Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Raphael, the Archangel, pray for us. San Roque, pray for us. San Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. San Pedro Calungsod, pray for us.
You are just, O Lord, and your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, the Father of every gift, we confess that all we have and are comes down from you. Teach us to recognize the effects of your boundless care, and to love you with a sincere heart and with all our strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, as you received Christ Jesus the Lord, walk in him, rooted in Him and built upon Him, and established in the faith as you were taught, abounding in thanksgiving. See to it that no one captivate you with an empty, seductive philosophy, according to tradition of man, according to the elemental powers of the world, and not according to Christ. For in Him dwells the fullness of the deity bodily, and you share in this fullness in Him, who is the head of every principality and power. In Him you were also circumcised, with a circumcision not administered by hand, by stripping off the carnal body with the circumcision of Christ. You were buried with Him in baptism, in which you were also raised with Him, through faith in the power of God, who raised Him from the dead. And even when you were dead in transgression and the uncircumcision of your flesh, He brought you to life along with Him, having forgiven us all our transgressions, obliterating the bond against us and its legal claims, which was opposed to us. He also removed it from our midst, nailing it to the cross, despoiling the principalities and the powers. He made a public spectacle of them, leading them away in triumph by it. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is compassionate toward all His works. I will extend to my God and King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. The Lord is compassionate toward all His works. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all His works. The Lord is compassionate toward all His works. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. The Lord is compassionate toward all His works. Alleluia! I chose you from the world, that you may go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord. Alleluia. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus departed to the mountain to pray, and He spent the night in prayer to God. When day came, He called His disciples to Himself, and from them He chose 12, whom He also named apostles: Simon, whom He named Peter, and his brother Andrew; James, John, Philip, Bartholomew; Matthew, Thomas, James, the son of Alphaeus; Simon, who was called a Zealot; and Judas, the son of James; and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. And He came down with them and stood on a stretch of level ground. A great crowd of His disciples and a large number of the people from all Judea and Jerusalem and the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon came to hear Him and to be healed of their diseases. And even those who were tormented by unclean spirits were cured. Everyone in the crowd sought to touch Him, because power came forth from Him and healed them all. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear brothers and sisters, in today's Gospel, Jesus went to the mountain to pray. The mountain is a symbolic place of encounter with God. In the Old Testament, Moses encountered God in the mountain, in Mount Horeb. The prophet Elijah encountered God in Mount Carmel. In the New Testament, the apostles were witnesses of the transfiguration of Jesus in Mount Tabor. Jesus teaches us to daily commune with God our Father. Just as he started his day praying, let us also start our day praying and throughout the day recognize that presence of God by talking to him, by conversing with him, even in the day-to-day occupation of our lives. Secondly, Jesus prayed when he was about to choose his apostles. Let us learn from the example of Jesus to pray over the choices that we make in life. May we learn to put God in our personal decisions in life so that everything might be considered in the presence of God and within the context of our salvation. Jesus started his day with prayer. Let us also start our day by praying always and recognizing that our strength comes from the Lord. The gospel tells us that Jesus cured the sick, and many of them were healed, not only those who were sick bodily, but also those who were with unclean spirits. Thus the gospel today tells us and concludes this way: everyone in the crowd sought to touch him, because power came forth from him and healed them all. We ask Jesus to touch us so that we can also touch the lives of our brothers and sisters, especially during this time of pandemic. Just as Jesus touched the life of his mother, Our Lady, let us ask Our Lady of Piat to touch us and bring us Jesus, so that Jesus would stretch out his hand upon us and heal us, not only of our bodily diseases, but also of our spiritual ailments. Let us seek the gift of integral healing through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, whose birthday we celebrate tomorrow. God calls his chosen ones to fulfill his will. Let us pray confidently to the Father, knowing that he wishes his people to intercede for the world. Father, hear us in Christ. That the Church, through the Pope and bishops, may lead us to the fullness of Christian life, let us pray to the Lord. Father, hear us in Christ. That statesmen may guide our nation to the future stability and development of our nation, let us pray to the Lord. Father, hear us in Christ. That we may persevere and be faithful in the vocation God has called us to undertake, let us pray to the Lord. Father, hear us in Christ. That the old, the sick, and the lonely may realize God's presence in their trials and difficulties, let us pray to the Lord. Father, hear us in Christ. That the dead may rest in peace of God's kingdom, let us pray to the Lord. Father, hear us in Christ. Almighty God, may we make these prayers. We come to do your will. Accept us in your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. For the gifts you have bestowed, O Lord, we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly begging that what you have conferred upon us in our unworthiness, we may give back to the glory of your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Ricardo, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. Amen. Let us pray. O God, you have given to us as spiritual food the saving sacrament of your Son, which we have offered you in thanksgiving. Grant that being strengthened by gifts of courage and joy, we may serve you more devotedly and be worthy of still further blessings. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. For the information of everyone, tomorrow is the birthday of the Blessed Virgin Mary, September 8. Let us gather together in the celebration of the Eucharist at 10 o'clock in the morning. The Basilica continues to be on lockdown, and let us wait for further details. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit, and may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.